I came to the University of Florida for graduate work to study with Archie Carr, who was the world's expert. He was just such a great person to work with, and he gave me opportunities that were really the foundation for my career. Right now, sea turtle populations are increasing in many areas of the world. But even with all of these increases in populations, the long-term outlook is dim because of the number of humans and crowding them out of the habitats that sea turtles need. Things like climate change and sea level rise are going to have major effects on those nesting beaches.
Karen and I have really developed the whole lifetime's work of exciting questions that we have spent our time pursuing and encouraging our graduate students to work towards these answers.
We met and I spent time with Karen in the field. I was taken along on some of these field trips just to lift the turtles, turn the turtles, help her weigh the turtles and measure the turtles. We continued to work together. We thought this was a nice life to have.
Being in the field is one opportunity that we can get our hands onto turtles, and that's the excitement.
Now that green turtles are recovering and starting to graze larger swaths of these seagrasses, the people are beginning to panic that green turtles are destroying the seagrass meadows. These long, lush pastures they're used to seeing are being reduced to these stubble fields. And so there have even been calls for reversing harvest bans, which would be disastrous. We're just now starting to recover these populations. We're working with our graduate students to try to evaluate just how much do these seagrass pastures change when they are grazed by green turtles.
While we have prepared the public and the scientific community has really invested and seen these populations recover, we still have a very limited understanding of how these animals even interact with their environment, particularly the foraging areas.
The health of their populations is a good reflection on these systems that we also depend on for food, ecosystem services, coastal protection, and recreation, and just joy. Everything I think the center does is contributing to conservation through research and education and communicating that research.
There's definitely hope, and we wouldn't all be here working so hard if we didn't see hope.